Jeanette Andrabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to determine the differential equation that governs the variation of the current during its decay in an RL series circuit fed by a square wave voltage. Give the expression of the current in its decay. Verify the solution of the differential equation. Give the value of the current at the instants 0, tau, and 5 tau. Draw the tangent to the curve I equal f of t at t0 equals 0. Draw the curves of UR and UL in current decay. Study the effect of the period of the feeding voltage on attaining the steady state in current growth and decay.
Differential equation that governs the decay of the current. In the circuit, we have a function generator providing a square wave voltage connected in series with a resistor of resistance R and a coil of inductance L and internal resistance small r. The voltage provided by the function generator is equal to E during half a period and zero during the second half. Now, to determine the differential equation during the decay of the current, we apply Kirchhoff's voltage law, but we must follow the positive sense. So we have UAB plus UBC plus UCA is equal to zero. Let's start with UCA. During the decay of the current, the voltage provided by the function generator is zero. UCA is zero, then UAC is zero. Now, UAB, look at the figure. UAB is the voltage across the coil. If you follow the positive sense, then the voltage across the coil is Ri plus LdI by dt. Now, UBC. UBC is equal to the voltage across the resistor. With the positive sense, the expression of the voltage across the resistor is plus Ri. Rearrange. This is going to be R plus capital R into I plus LdI by dt is equal to 0. Divide the equation by L. This is going to be di by dt plus r times I over L is equal to 0. This is the first order differential equation that governs the variation of I during the current decay.
Now, expression of the current during its decay. By referring to the differential equation obtained in the previous slide, the solution of this equation is given by I equal Im e to the power minus t over tau, where Im and tau are constants. Im is the maximum value of the current and is given by E over R plus R, and tau is called the time constant of the circuit and is given by L over R plus R. So, the expression of the current during its decay is given by I equal E over R plus R times E to the power minus R plus R over L times t. So, the obtained expression shows that the current decreases exponentially with time. This current starts maximum Im and decreases to zero.
Verification of the solution. This is the solution of the obtained differential equation. So, we need to differentiate I with respect to time, and then we will substitute the obtained expression into the differential equation. First, let me remind you with the derivative of the exponential function. Y is a function of time. Y is equal to e to the power u. Then the derivative of y with respect to time is equal to u prime e to the power u. So minus t over tau is taken as u. Now let's differentiate the current with respect to time. Di by dt is equal to Im into. Now minus 1 over tau is equal to u prime, and the exponential is equal to e to the power u. Now this is going to be di by dt is equal to minus im over tau e to the power minus t over tau. Replace di by dt in the differential equation by this expression and replace the current by this expression. This is going to be minus Im over tau times e to the power minus t over tau plus small r plus capital R over L into Im e to the power minus t over tau. Now, is this going to be zero? Let's see. You know that the time constant of the RL circuit is equal to L over small r plus capital R. This is the time constant for our RL circuit. Now, this is going to be 1 over tau is equal to R plus R over L. So, we will replace R plus R over L in the above expression by 1 over tau. This is going to be minus Im over tau times e to the power minus t over tau plus Im over tau times e to the power minus t over tau. Is this term or is the sum of these two terms equal zero? Yes, it is equal to zero. So the solution is verified.
Now, by referring to the expression of the current during its decay, let's determine some particular values of the current at specific instants and when t tends to infinity. Let's start when t equals 0. Substitute t equals 0 in the expression of the current. So I of 0 is equal to Im e to the power 0. But e to the power 0 is equal 1. Then, during its decay, the current starts maximum. Now, for t equal tau. Similarly, substitute t equal tau in the expression of the current, then I equal Im e to the power minus tau over tau, which is equal to Im e to the power minus 1. But e to the power minus 1 is equal to 0.37. So at equal tau, I equal 0.37 Im. What does that mean? At equal tau, 63% of the whole decay process is completed, or the value of the current at equal tau is equal to 37% of its maximum value.
Let's move to the instant 5 tau. Replace t in the expression of the current by 5 tau. This is going to be Im e to the power minus 5 tau over tau, which is equal to Im e to the power minus 5. Then I is approximately equal to 0.01 Im, which is approximately equal to 0. Look at the figure. This is tau. Here we have 2 tau, 3 tau, 4 tau, 5 tau. So here we have t equal 5 tau. At t equal 5 tau, the current is approximately equal to 0. And after this, we can say that the current does not change anymore. We can say this. Practically, it does not change anymore. Then, at t equal 5 tau, 99% of the current decay is completed. Practically, we can say that the steady state is attained. Now, when t tends to infinity, use this expression. The current tends to zero. Finally, I want to give you the definition of the time constant tau of the series RL circuit. Tau is the time needed by the current flowing in the coil to grow or to decay 63% of its maximum value.
Focus, please. This is important.
Tangent to the curve I equal f of t at t0 equals 0. The graph shows two curves. The blue curve represents the current during its decay as a function of time, while the red curve is the tangent to I at t equals 0, and we notice that the red curve cuts the horizontal asymptote of equation I1 equal to 0 at a point of abscissa t1. In this slide, we are going to determine the value of t1. We know that the expression of the current during its decay is equal Im e to the power minus t over tau. And the time derivative of this current proved before, which is equal to minus Im over tau e to the power minus t over tau. So at t equals 0, di by dt is equal to minus im over tau e to the power 0. But e to the power 0 is equal to 1. Therefore, di by dt at equal to 0 is equal to minus im over tau. But we know that di by dt at equal 0 is the slope of the tangent to the curve I equal f of t at the instant t0 equal to 0. But this slope can be determined graphically, and it is given by delta I over delta t. So we take 2 points from the curve. The first point of abscissa t1 and ordinate 0, and the second point of abscissa 0 and ordinate im. So the slope is given by 0 minus im over t1 minus 0, which is equal to minus im over t1. Now we have two expressions of the same slope. So slope equals slope, and by comparison, minus im over tau is equal to minus im over t1. So we can conclude that t1 is equal to tau. Therefore, the tangent to the curve I equal f of t at t0 equals 0 meets the horizontal asymptote of equation I1 equals 0 at a point of abscissa tau.
We have studied the curve of the current in the decay process. Now let's study the curves of UR, the voltage across the resistor, and UL, the voltage across the coil. We will take UAB equal UL and UBC equal UR in the adjacent circuit. Now let's apply Kirchhoff's voltage law, and we will follow the positive sense. So UAB plus UBC is equal to UAC, but the function generator provides a square wave voltage whose value is zero during the current decay. So UAC is equal to zero. Replace UAC by zero, UBC by UR, and UAB by UL in this expression. This is going to be UL plus UR is equal to zero, then UR is equal to minus UL. The expression of the current in the current decay is Im e to the power minus t over tau. How can we get the expression of UR? Follow the positive sense. UBC, which is equal to UR, is equal to plus RI. Replace I by Im e to the power minus t over tau. This is going to be UR is equal to RIm e to the power minus t over tau. This shows that the voltage across the resistor decreases exponentially with time. Now, at t0 equals 0, UR0 is equal to RIm e to the power minus 0 over tau. You know that e to the power 0 is equal to 1. This is going to be UR0 is equal to RIm, but we know that UR is equal to minus UL. This equation is always correct. So UL0 is equal to minus UR0, which is equal to minus RIm. Now we are ready to draw the curves. So as you see, this is the red curve is for UR versus time. Well, this shows you that UR decreases exponentially with time, and at t0 equals 0, UR0 is equal to plus RIm. And the curve of UL has the same shape. They have the same absolute value, but UL is equal to minus UR. And at t0 equals 0, UL is equal to minus RIm.
We proved that the growth and the decay processes of the current are attained practically at t equal 5 tau. Consider an RL series circuit connected across a generator delivering a square wave voltage of period t. Let's study two cases. First case, if 5 tau greater than t over 2. We know that tau depends only on the inductance and the resistance of the circuit, while the period t depends on the frequency of the generator. and T over 2 represents the time interval of each of the growth and the decay process of the current. So when 5 tau greater than T over 2, then the steady state of the current is not attained, and the current is neither reached its maximum value nor its minimum value, as shown on the figure. On the next slide, you will watch an experimental simulation which verifies this result. Now, let's study the second case. If 5 tau much greater than T over 2, let's study the growth of the current. I, or the expression of the current during its growth, is given by Im into 1 minus exponential minus T over tau. If 5 tau much greater than T over 2, so we can write tau much greater than the period over 2. But the time T varies between 0 and period over 2. When tau is much greater than T over 2, so we can write tau much greater than the time T, but using mathematical expression. When tau is much greater than T, e to the power minus t over tau can be written as 1 or approximately equal 1 minus t over tau. Now, replace e to the power minus t over tau by 1 minus t over tau. So I is given by Im into 1 minus 1 plus t over tau. 1 minus 1 becomes 0. So the expression of the current during its growth becomes Im over tau times t. That means I varies linearly with time with a slope Im over tau. Also, on the next slide, you will watch an experimental simulation which verifies this result. Consider a series RL circuit connected across a generator delivering a square wave voltage of frequency f equal to 150 Hz. Then the period of the generator, which is given by t equal 1 over f equal 4 milliseconds. So, T over 2 equal 2 milliseconds. The resistance of the resistor is R equal 1 kilo ohm. This experimental simulation studies two cases referring to the values of L. First case, L is equal to 700 millihenry. Then 5 tau, which is given by 5L over R equal 3.5 milliseconds. Therefore, the growth and the decay processes of the current need a time of 3.5 milliseconds to reach the steady state. Since 3.5 milliseconds greater than 2 milliseconds, therefore the steady state is not attained. Now let's start the simulation. The red curve represents UG as a function of time, while the blue curve represents the voltage across R as a function of time, but the voltage across R is similar to that of the current. We notice that the current neither reaches its maximum value nor reaches its minimum value. Now, let's study the second case. If we vary L from 700 millihenry into 7 henry, in this case, the value of 5 tau becomes 35 milliseconds, which is much greater than that of 2 milliseconds. So, the curve that represents the current as a function of time during its growth and decay can be considered as a straight line, or the current varies linearly with time.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.